Hi everyone. So in this example, let's do one simple exercise. What we are going to do is we are going to write simple route handler. So there may be a different kind of URL you will be hitting, like login.html, index.html, and then we should be able to respond to a particular page, not always index.html, right? So this is server.js, and we have another module, app module, and we are actually getting handle request method from there. Okay. So we can start writing code in app.js. Here we can just create our functions. So first of all, what we need to do export from this is we have to export some function module.exports, and here this handle request method we have to expose, right? So that our server.js can access this handle request. Okay. So what this handle request is doing, this is nothing but a function. This function should be able to handle our request response. So I have a request and response, and based on some particular argument, I will be able to check what is the URL. URL is a login or a forward slash. Okay. So first of all, what we will do, response dot here right head. I mean, we'll just write here the status and the content type. Content type, which is text HTML, because we are sending text content. Okay, this is the basic thing we have done. Now we have to check the path, what path we are getting from the request. So we are getting URL. Okay, url.parse we can do, and whatever the request we are getting, request.url, url.path name, this is how we can get. Okay, here we will get a path name. Now you can write a simple switch case based on the path we have got, and what this switch case will do, if case is forward slash, right, in that case we have to render index.html, render, okay, simple render function we can create, where we can just pass the file name. I have index.html and response, because we have to write this in the response object. Similarly, if case is different, I will just put a break here. Just do the alignment. Here, if path comes out as a login, then we will just render the login.html. Okay, for the default case, what we can say is route not found, response.write ahead, and these basic syntax we can add. So that is for default case, and once everything is done, we can just say response.end. Okay, for the default case. Now we have to write this render function, so we can write function render here. Before that, we have to import the URL module and FS module, because we will be using both the modules to deal with the files. Okay, in this render function, we are getting the path of the file and the response object. Now what we need to do, we just need to write fs.read file. fs.read file, we are passing the path and content, I mean the encoding, which can be null, and here we can just have a function, and which will have an error and comma data. If we got any data from that, if we got any error, then we have to deal with that accordingly, because Node.js is error first callback. It is complaining here. Okay, I'm using both, that's the problem. Here I can just send response.write head 404. Same logic here, unable to read data. If this is not the case, then we can just write the data from the file response.write data and response.send, right? So this is the basic example we have created. We are exporting from these. So we are covering a lot of concepts here. How to export a function and how to import it in another file. Here we are doing require and we are calling this handle request function. You can just convert this into a callback function as we are using most of the ESX features. Okay, yeah, this looks nice now. So this is how you can actually deals with the routing without Express. I mean, we are not using Express. We are just checking what is the path name. Based on that, we can decide what need to be rendered, either content type. Content type can be application JSON or text HTML based on what you are rendering.